attention in front of the press. Like sweep and do a little in front of the press. And also make sure someone gets a picture of you and Rebecca and send it to me, please. The person sitting in front of you. Like just need to give them your phone and then text it to me. Okay, bye. Yay, bye.
Thank you! was that?
Nothing good?
We did what we could.
But dude, you're still alive right now?
Yes.
Okay,
yeah, we got 23,000 watching.
Alright, cool.
Is the group that is opted not to be arrested. And here's our group that is chosen to be arrested. Police made it very clear about 15 or 20 minutes ago that we need to be here on this side of the line.
Democracy!
You'd think there would be
100,000 people, but you know, the Moral Monday movement in 2013, April 29th, 2013, 17 people got arrested. Before the summer was over, 1,000 people had gotten arrested, and they would have crowds of 10,000 there every Monday. So, what's happening right now is that this month belongs to a TYT employee named Chris, and I don't know how many thousand other phones. All of these video cameras with the congressional press, they are amplifying this message. They're witnessing and amplifying this message. And it may be that more people come tomorrow to get arrested. It may be that more people come the next day. When you get arrested for civil disobedience, it doesn't like, it's not something that employers in the future are going to count against you. It's not anyone that you'd want to work for. When I got arrested at Occupy, the reason why I don't want to do it again as a journalist is that I lost footage as a result. I thought I was treated. They inflicted some pain on me, basically, that I didn't appreciate. It was sort of terrifying to have the government use physical force to basically state that you don't want to occupy a place around anymore. By the way, there was a lawsuit, and they actually paid me $12,000, along with 300 other people that were arrested on this day. It was around Thanksgiving of 2011. Okay, what is happening is that a group of concerned citizens, including Cenk, are sitting at the steps of the United States Capitol. Protests the undue influence of money in politics and the attempts to restrict voting in the wake of actually not just the 2008 election results but also the 2000 census, which showed that our country was becoming more diverse racially. They've been working on voting restrictions ever since, behind the scenes for a number of years, but the first voter ID law was put in place in 2006. Imagine that, we didn't have any kinds of... Okay, what you see right now is these police officers are arresting the first person. It looks like they have over 100 to arrest. It's going to be a while. I'm sorry I can't get you a closer angle, but we have other people doing this. I'm going to start filming with our good camera. We're back to Chris. Chris, if you want to... Okay.
Today, they may well be getting arrested.
Christmas to tomorrow. The brave people, including Jake, are in there to be the first sacrificial lambs. If this is modeled after Moral Monday, you guys should look it up. If this goes the way Moral Monday did, it will amplify, it will grow.
Thank you for protecting and serving us.
The voice that you hear, try to get a shot of this guy in the wig behind him.
Yes? Those probably are.
Everything is okay, folks. The government is not corrupt. There's no need to get money out. You are free to vote, Democrat or Republican. Things will change. Who cares if they're owned by the same company? To arrest more non-violent offenders. There's way too many empty private prison cells.
Yes, there are.
Yes. I think I smell pot. Arrest everyone. It's dangerous. It's dangerous to pharmaceutical companies. It's dangerous.
Yes.
It's dangerous to alcohol companies, and we need to protect them. One nation heavily drugged, independently corrupt. This is what democracy looks like. We better arrest everyone. We can't have democracy in a republic controlled by corporations, can we?
It's very inconvenient.
There's way too many empty private prison cells, officers. Please.